but you're having problems with recording mic inputs. The master fader seems to be controlling the input level, which shouldn't be really happening.
If you're a first-time viewer,
hi, my name is Daniel, and I make music. I help you understand music production, music theory, and live sound engineering. And today I'm gonna be explaining as simply as possible the routing menu in the X32 and M32 consoles. I was trying to do the intro outside. It's a beautiful sunny day, and then some lovely kids saw me filming and they were like, hey, let's start screaming and making noises and shouting and let's ruin his video, which they did. But you're here to learn about the routing matrix in the X32 and M32 consoles, so let's do that. Before I start explaining, if you're not on the latest firmware update, come on, go update your console. It takes like 2 minutes. Go to the Midas website or the Behringer website and download the latest firmware update, put it on a USB stick, go plug that USB stick into your console and update it. Okay, you're done. Okay, we're good to go. My first advice would be, if your routing is too messed up, go and reset your console. Now, if you don't want to reset it because you don't want to lose any scenes, go ahead and make a new scene and initialize the console, and that will reset the routing. If the routing is set to the default settings, you shouldn't have any problems connecting it to the DAW, but I will show you which input goes where and which output. I'll show you. Okay, so what I'm doing here is I'm trying to like simulate a recording situation. So I connected output one to input one and then went to the monitor section, oscillator, and generate pink noise from bus number one. And that signal is feeding back into channel one. So I have a running signal through the channel while I'm explaining. And we will consider that as the signal or mic or instrument that you want to record. Now, the good thing about recording through a mixer is that you can actually listen to what you're recording in a very low latency because you're actually listening through the console. But you want to also be able to listen to what's going on in the session, maybe a click track or other instrumentation or whatever. So what we need to do right now is get the master output of the session back into the mixer. A best practice, or at least what I think is a really good practice, is to use the last two channels to monitor the session. So on the console, it will be channel 31 and 32. So we will go to your any DAW, I'm using Pro Tools now, and set the output of all the tracks to out 31 and 32, and the input of whatever you're recording to that channel. There are basically two ways to do the routing on the mixer. You can either go to the last block of inputs, go down and select card 25 to 32, and now you can see there's a signal going through these channels, but this will prevent you from using channels 25 to 30 to record, because you basically told the console that channels 25 to 32 are getting their inputs from the card or the DAW, which is maybe Pro Tools, Ableton Reaper, whatever it is. The second and best way to do it is go to the last block of inputs, go all the way down, but now select user 25 to 32, go all the way to the right to the user tab, find the channels 31 and 32, and give them as inputs card 31 and card 32. Now you can see there's a signal going through the channels. And that's why I told you in the beginning of the video to go and update your mixer, because in any version previous to version 4 of the firmware, you couldn't do that. Now you can use all 30 channels for recording and the last two for monitoring. Oh, also don't forget to link your monitoring channels. So select channel 31, go to the home page, click on link, confirm, and now 31 is your left channel and 32 is your right channel. Now you don't need to do that, but it kind of makes your life a little bit easier, so just do it. Okay, one last thing. You might think that this should be like obvious, right? But I feel like I need to say it. This is the headphones knob. It controls the output level of these two headphone jacks on the bottom of the console. This is the monitor knob, and it controls the level of the monitor out on the back of the console. And this is the main fader, which controls the level of the main outputs on the back of the console, out 15 and 16. So if you don't remember anything I said in this video, please remember this. If you're using your mixer in a studio environment, don't plug your speakers into the main outputs. Just plug them into the monitor out. It makes your life much easier. You don't have to mess with the main fader. If you are using a microphone, you can just turn down the monitor knob, turn up the headphones knob. Boom. And that's all I had to say. Maybe send this video to your friend who is so confused about this mixer, because I don't blame you. It is kind of confusing. And if you found this helpful, give this video a like. Apparently it helps. And subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.